Nithyanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gagana sadrisham tatvamasyadilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam sadgurum tam namami.
We welcome all the Shri Mahans, Mahans, Kotaris, Thanedars, Balasanths, disciples, devotees, Samajis, Satsangis, visitors and viewers to this Vaakyartha Sadhas connected by Balasanths of Nithyananda Gurukul. The topic for today's Vaakyartha Sadhas is Guru Bhakti.
I have a question. Can anyone tell what is Guru Bhakti?
What I feel is completely surrender to the Master.
What I feel is being the space of positivity and possibility.
Just adding to a point, what I feel as Guru Bhakti is being an integrity to the words you give to the Master, having, you know, like the space of devotion towards the Master and ready to sacrifice anything for the Master is what I feel as Guru Bhakti.
I have a question. What do you mean by positivity and possibility?
What I feel as possibility is when you constantly know that everything is possible and not having any impossibility. See, basically in all of our lives, there will be many situations where we think, oh no, this is not possible for me, I'm too weak for this, no, only my senior can do this, I can't take up that. Like this, we put many blockages for our life. So what I feel is completing all these blockages and knowing you can manifest your reality. Anything you want can be created by you is possibility, and working towards it with a space of completion, what I feel is positivity.
Then I have a question, like then what's the difference between aligning our four images and being in the space of possibility? Are they both the same?
What I feel is, when we align to all our four images, the authentic identities which we carry, naturally we get into the space of possibilities. Because see, the four images are the ones we feel can be the most authentic for us. So naturally aligned to them, what I feel is we'll be in the highest possibility of life. That very images you carry about life and decisions you take based on them will be totally expanding, and you can just go into the space of possibility. So what I feel is aligning your four images is one of the ways to get into the space of possibility.
I have a question. Swamiji told me on satsang, Guru Bhakti is first step for everything. What does Swamiji mean by that?
What I feel about Swamiji meant by saying that for any doing anything, the Guru Bhakti is first and foremost. It's like, see, even if you're going to go pray to the Master or ask him for a boon, the first thing we all require is trust, knowing that the Master is a person who is going to do something very good for us. Just like what Swamiji told, for the Master to do anything, you have to have a certain limit of trust to let him inside. See, Master, Mahadeva, all of them are just waiting out, just outside our doors of our inner space to come in and clean us. But we only resisting with our incomplete, no, I need all this, for this many years I've been living with them, how can you just come and tell you have to take everything away? So even for letting the Master inside you, what I feel is you have to have a little bit of trust on the Master and a little devotion to the Master. Only then you'll have the confidence that yes, the Master only wants my good, he'll only do things from expansion, and you let him to do what has to be done. Otherwise, immediately in the middle of the process, you'll think, no, I'm getting too much of pain. Just like Swamiji told, when sometimes the Master has to take an incompletion of the force, and if we don't have trust or devotion to the Master at that point, we'll just not let the process happen. This is what I feel by what Swamiji meant by saying, Guru Bhakti is the first step for everything.
What I feel is only when you exaggerate on the Guru and have Guru Bhakti, only then like any action you do will be out of completion. Otherwise, if you only exaggerate on yourself, then only you'll be exaggerating on incompletion in you. But if you exaggerate on the Guru and have Guru Bhakti and constantly live in the space of Guru Bhakti, then you will exaggerate everything on Swamiji, and Swamiji will just flow through you and do all the actions through you. I have a question, what's the difference between Guru Bhakti and seeking? Because even Guru Bhakti and seeking, you're doing the same action, exaggerating on the Master. So what's the difference between Guru Bhakti and seeking?
What I feel is both are just the same, because even in the Guru Bhakti Satsang, Swamiji defined Guru Bhakti as aligning your four images to your highest possibility, to Shivoham. And even in seeking, you're just constantly reinventing yourself to find out your possibilities and reinvent yourself more and more. So in both, you're just reinventing yourself to discover yourself. So what I feel is both are same.
Just adding to a point, what I feel is when you start to become in the space of Guru Bhakti, the Guru Bhakti itself will just take the space of seeking. And naturally when seeking, just seeking more and more, we'll start getting the trust in the Master and ourselves. So we think, yes, the Master is really somebody, is God. And even I can do it. This truth is not for anybody else, but it's for me also. And I can manifest all this. So we get into more Guru Bhakti. So naturally we get into more Guru Bhakti, we get into more seeking. So what I feel is they both go hand in hand. So when we have Guru Bhakti, we get into seeking, and when we have seeking, we get into Guru Bhakti.
I have a question about what Mitra said. He said as we seek more and more, we'll just get into more trust. But doesn't seeking itself start with trust? So in order to seek, you need to have trust, right?
What I feel is, see, when we have Guru Bhakti in the starting, we will have like initially little amount of trust on the Master that yes, the Master only wants for my expansion, he does not want anything else. But when we see that the Guru Bhakti, you know, is leading us to higher and higher levels, is giving us more and more experiences, we start gaining more and more trust on ourselves and the Master. See, we gain more trust that yes, the Master is giving me so many experiences, he must be God. So we understand that the Guru is our God. And then we also understand that the truths are not meant for anybody else. The Master is speaking to me. These truths, whatever the Master is giving, can be applied to me also. So when we get into this space, what I feel is we'll just go into more Guru Bhakti. We'll be in such a space of gratitude. We'll just be so, like, have so much of gratitude towards the Master, we'll go into more Guru Bhakti. So what I feel is we'll have a little bit trust, but as you get Guru Bhakti and move into seeking, we'll start getting more and more trust from the Master and yourself.
What I feel is Guru Bhakti and seeking lead to each other.
A question, how do we strengthen our Guru Bhakti every day more and more?
What I feel is every day if you listen to Swamiji's satsang and apply into your life, you can be in Guru Bhakti.
Just adding to this point, what I feel is when we constantly live in the Nithyananda, we have cognition. That is when we just put a whole trust on Swamiji's words and start living our life and planning our day-to-day routine from it, we can just jump into the space of Guru Bhakti.
I have a question. What do you mean by living in the space of Nithyananda way of cognition?
What I feel is, see, now Swamiji gives us many truths in our this morning satsang. So when we take all of these truths, even if we think that no, maybe it's not possible for me, just applying it in our life, knowing that yes, Swamiji has told it and Swamiji's words can never go wrong. So it has to work for me. So just doing all the actions and planning your day-to-day routine based on Swamiji's truths and from this cognition is what I feel by the Nithyananda way of cognition.
What I feel is like how Swamiji said, just by being in the space of gratitude, like our day starts off with Pada Puja. If we do Pada Puja authentically from the space of gratitude, then we'll obviously carry that feeling throughout the day. And Swamiji said we're in the space of gratitude and devotion, nothing can even bother us. Nothing can even affect us in our life. So when we're in the space of gratitude and devotion, we'll just feel like listening to Swamiji's words and living that in our life. So what I feel is just by being in the space of gratitude.
What I feel is trusting Swamiji's word and applying in life, that's called Nithyananda cognition.
I have a question. See, Swamiji said by being in the space of listening, we'll be led to more and more completion. But listening to life, does that just mean listening to everything what everyone is telling around you?
What I feel is what Swamiji meant by saying listening to life will lead you to more and more completion is like, see, now life is constantly giving us more and more situations for us to understand something or expand from it. Or if we complete the completion, for us to learn how to get others in the space of completion also. So what I feel is, whenever life gives a situation, trying to understand what life wants us to understand or what life wants us to complete from this situation is what I feel is what Swamiji meant by saying, listening to life will lead you into more and more completion.
But in that situation, you're only perceiving that life is doing this to me, so life is helping me transform. So there is just your perception. How is it listening?
See, For example, if like this situation, like when we are small, somebody, like we eating many chocolates, somebody came and took away our chocolates. So if you're normally perceiving it, or if you're in the space of incompletion, if you're not listening to life, you might think, oh, this person is very angry, he is grabbing chocolates away from me, he does not want me to enjoy chocolates. But if you're listening towards life, you'll start thinking, why did life present me this situation? What does life want me to complete? And immediately understand, yes, I ate so many chocolates, I had a greed for chocolates, immediately decide to complete the pattern of having greed. So what if in this, like just like this example, what if it is in every situation you must listen to life and what it wants to tell you, what life is trying to tell you, and understanding that truth and completing and cognizing it is what I feel what Swamiji meant by saying listening to life will lead you to more and more completion.
What I feel is every time life is trying to tell you something. So when you just receive and listen to what life is trying to tell you, whatever life wants to tell you, will be in listening, and life will always bring more and more completion in you. So each time you listen to life around you, that will bring more and more completion inside you.
What I feel is, see, now in our day-to-day life, we are out of listening with many things, we're not listening with many things, even the like, small things around us. So what I feel is, first you must start aligning ourselves to the things around us. You must start listening to the person. For example, in our job, if our boss comes and tells us something, instead of me getting agitated, oh, my boss told me to do it within this minute, how can I do? Instead of getting a space of incompletion, what I feel is like the small things you must start cognizing and think of a space of possibility and positivity. Slowly, you must, from the things around you, you must move to little larger things. Like this, when you constantly keep expanding yourself in a space of possibility and positivity, what I feel is you can start listening to life.
What I feel is, if you have Guru Bhakti and exhortation on Swamiji, you can listen to life.
I have a question. Doesn't listening lead to Guru Bhakti?
What I feel is both goes in hand in hand.
What I feel is yes, because whenever, like for example, if Swami is giving satsang and you are having Guru Bhakti, and like when you listen to Swami satsang, instead of having incomplete inside you, you will just like keep on be listening to Swamiji and get enriched by whatever he is saying. So what I feel, and you will be having Guru Bhakti towards Swamiji. So what I feel is, as you listen more and more to Swamiji, you will be having more and more Guru Bhakti towards him.
What I feel is, if you are aligning to your context, you can listen to your life.
What I also feel is Guru Bhakti is like how Swamiji said, when we have our four images of Shivoham. Another easy way, another technique which Swamiji told in one of the recent satsangs is that we're just doing everything from the context that Soham is me. That means I am you and you are me. So once we start connecting with the deities, not from a lower inner image thinking we're something low or down, when we connect to the deities thinking that I am you and you are me, then obviously they'll call your realities and you'll start experiencing that you're really that. So what I feel is, by just being in that space of Advaita Pradhana, will be led to the space of Guru Bhakti.
I have a question. In one of the satsangs, Swamiji told, being authentic to Guru is Guru Bhakti. How can you be authentic to Guru?
What I feel is, what Swamiji meant by saying being authentic to the Guru is like, see, no, Swamiji has an anyakara for all of us. He wants us to know, like, be in a space of completion. He has many anyakaras for all of us. So being aligned to that anyakara, doing everything to fulfill Swamiji's anyakara, and you know, fulfilling what Swamiji wants out of us and being integrated with Swamiji is what I feel is being authentic with your connection with the Guru.
I have a question about what we were discussing a few minutes ago. Like, we define this listening as when we know that the whole world is just aligning itself to help us and help us reinvent ourselves. But then, like listening, Swamiji said, listening is just when you understand things just as it is without adding your own patterns and perceptions into it. So how will listening even lead us to a space of Guru Bhakti?
What I feel is, see, now just like what Swamiji told us, listening is perceiving the world as it is without putting any of our incompletions. Because whenever we put our incompletion in any situation, we start thinking the situation completely different way. For example, if our friend had borrowed a pencil from us, instead of just seeing, yes, my friend has borrowed a pencil from me, we'll just start seeing, oh, my friend does not want me to write the notes, he wants me to go down and study just because I'm more better than him. We'll just start putting all of our incompletion layers, and no, we'll not perceive the situation correctly. So what I feel is, when we're in space of listening, when you perceive the world as it is, if somebody takes anything from us, we see, yes, this person has taken this thing from us. So slowly, even we start pursuing the truth. From the truth we move towards reality. So naturally we move towards the reality. What I feel is we'll start being such a deep space of gratitude towards the master. Because the master who taught you how to be in space of listening, and he's the one who's guiding you at every step. You'll also understand this truth. So naturally when you start having gratitude towards the master for whatever he's taught you and helped you on the way, what I feel is you just get into the space of Guru Bhakti.
But how do we perceive the world just as it is without putting our patterns? Because perception itself happens from our patterns and our understanding. So how can we perceive the world just as it is?
See, what I feel is now we have many situations in life, we just start putting our own patterns and incompletions. So whenever we see that yes, we are putting our patterns, we must just be aware that whenever you're putting a pattern, immediately deciding to drop that pattern. For example, if we have an incompletion towards somebody, and whenever they're interacting with us, we put the incompletion on them. Immediately, you must just recognize, yes, this person is not trying to convey anything like that to me, I'm just putting my incompletion. So immediately, you must complete that incompletion which you might have had with your friend. Just like how Swamiji defines completion, you must really realize the situation. Because if you have an incompletion, there must be a root cause for it. So what I feel is you must just relive the root cause and relieve that incompletion. So slowly start completing all of your incompletions and you'll be able to perceive the world as it is without any incompletions.
What I feel is Guru Bhakti is aligning all your four images to Shivam. So as you listen to life and you keep on listening to life around you, you learn so much from life and you will know to align all your four images to Shivam, because Shivam is ultimate space. So when you listen to life, you'll just know what is Shivoham, and you'll just align all your four images, and so listening leads you to Guru Bhakti.
Just adding to this point, what I feel is when we start listening authentically to life, completing all of our incompletions, instead listening authentically to life, life will just bring us the master. Because constantly we are saying yes towards the life, we just know because life wants us all to experience Vaishnava Shivoham. So naturally when life starts seeing that yes, we are starting to say yes to life and we are completing all the situations, life itself will lead us to Mahadeva so that we can achieve the space of Shivoham. So what if all we have to do is just listen to life and life itself will take you towards the master.
I have a question. Does master happen to us because of our seeking or because of his love?
What I feel is, in the initial stages, you might be seeking that when we understand that all things we are running around, money, wealth, health, is not the ultimate. Enlightenment is ultimate. When we just start realizing this, we start seeking for enlightenment. So slowly we are seeking for enlightenment, master happens in our life. But that does not mean only because of seeking the master happens in our life. Just like how Swamiji told us at Sang, only when I decided to take interest in you, you decided to take interest in me. So only when the master decides to see who you are and take interest in you and lead you to Shivoham, we will even start having interest that yes, there is Swamiji who can leave me in space and start having Guru Bhakti. So what I feel is, in the starting it's our seeking. So when he constantly has space seeking, the master himself will take us towards him and just give us the gift of Shivoham.
What I feel is only it's because of the master even we start seeking. Only because the master wants us to come to him, and when it's the right time for us to come to him, he even awakens the seeking inside us, and at last we see the master. So what I feel is it's all because of the master that we all are here.
Just adding a point, even what I also feel is it's because of the master's love that we're seeking. Yes, Swamiji has said that because of our janmas of good decision and all we're here, but We decided to even start seeking because of the master's love. Only because the divine intervention even happened before, we started to seek and make good decisions to again be with the master. So what I feel is how Swamiji said, before we see him, he sees us. So he's the one who saw us, and his love is on everybody. But we're the ones who decided to start seeking the last birth. That's why we're with him now. So what I feel is it's because of the master's love that he's in our life now.
What I feel is this December 2008 Nithyanandoham, if you go, you will experience the Guru Bhakti.
Just adding to this point, what I feel is when we all attend the Nithyanandoham 2008, all of us can experience the Guru Bhakti. Because just like what Swamiji told, the Shivoham process, he worked on our bio-memory. So all of our possibilities get awakened in us. But in the Nithyanandoham process, it's going to happen in December, Swami is going to awaken all of his possibilities in us. So when we see his possibilities getting awakened in us, we will just understand that yes, Swamiji is Guru and Guru is God. So when we understand this truth, we will just get into such a deep space of Guru Bhakti. We will know, like, just experience the space of Nithyananda.
I have a question. See, Swamiji said Guru Bhakti is when you align our four images to Shivoham. That is like knowing your Shiva. But then when you know your Shiva, when you know your everything, you will not think anything is separate from you and you won't even pray from that context. How can you have Guru Bhakti at that point? How is that Guru Bhakti?
What I feel is, when we start realizing that we are Mahadeva, and you know, we understand, yes, everything is a part of me and I am part of everything, we'll just get a deep sense of bhakti, because we'll know that, yes, who made me realize all of this? I couldn't have achieved this space and I am part of everything without my Guru. So the whole thing, the credit goes to my Guru. We just be in the space of devotion and gratitude towards our Guru, that even after achieving the space of Shivoham, we'll just know that, yes, even though I achieved this, the Guru is the one who made me get all this. So what I feel is, even after we achieve the space of Shivoham, we will start having a much deeper space of Guru Bhakti.
What I feel like what Mitra said, Swami said once that even though he's enlightened, he knows he's Avatar Purusha, he has a deep surrender and gratitude to his master for bringing him to that space and make him realize that he's an incarnation. So what if even after we know that we are everything and we know that we are Shivoham, even then we should have the deep gratitude and surrender to Swamiji to help us and to reach that state.
What I understood in today's Vakyartha Sadhas is that in any situation of our life, you must just have the Guru Bhakti. And just like what Swamiji told, Guru Bhakti itself is an independent technique to lead us to enlightenment. And even after we start achieving space of enlightenment and Shivoham and all of that, we'll constantly have space of Guru Bhakti. Because see, even after achieving enlightenment, we'll just know that who made me achieve this space of enlightenment? It's my Guru. It's a divine intervention which caused me to achieve this space of enlightenment. So knowing this truth, we'll just be in a space of more Guru Bhakti. Plus, I also understood that when we start seeking, that is also because of the master only. So because the master's grace, we start seeking, and even after seeking, we just seek to get the master's grace. And we can achieve all of this by just coming to Nithyanandaham. So what I feel is, the only thing we almost all have in our mind to achieve all of this is just like what Swamiji told, Nithyanandaham chalo. With this, we come to the conclusion of this Vakyartha Sadhas, and we'll continue to explore the deeper truths of further Vakyartha Sadhas. Now we'll end with the Purna Mantra.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tatsat Sarvam Sadguru Padukar Panamasto Om Nitya